Hi, I'm Jennifer Shaffer, and this is Hacking the Afterlife podcast with
Richard Martini. Yay! Hello, Jennifer.
Hey, Richard.
How are you?
You know, as expected on a very full supermoon day.
Lots of clients, lots of stuff, lots of people texting you, stuff going on.
I am grateful. I have to keep telling myself. I love what I do for work. But it has been quite
taxing, problematic.
Taxing, but no, not really. It's just I want it. Like, I have really put myself as a visitor of this planet, like not an alien, mind you, but just like, you know, we don't take things with us. Like, why get upset over other things? Just, you know, to be more present. I've done that, but today it just doesn't work. Like, I've done everything. I've worked out today. I've done everything that I could, but yet I was still running behind a little bit. And then I don't know. I'm trying my best not to judge it, like you've always said.
Yeah.
Don't judge it. But every single lunch meeting, every single dinner, I have events all the time. It's kind of crazy if I think about it. I just kind of just have to.
Everything has been a little askew. Was that what you're saying?
Yeah, in a great way. Like, they had the celebration for the magazine article that I was in for the South Bay magazine.
Oh yeah, that's right. By the way, watch me snap my fingers. Let's see, did it work? Yeah. Okay. I've got a new backdrop. You know, it's funny because I had chosen this other backdrop and then it disappeared. So everything has been. But I want to thank Iman, the model, for taking this photograph. I don't know her. I borrowed it.
I love it.
From her page. And I just thought, oh, what a beautiful photograph of fall colors. Trees and whatnot. For the people driving in their car, what are they talking about? I've got a new backdrop behind me of fall trees. I think it's upstate New York or wherever it is. David Bowie and Iman used to have a place. So, Jennifer, I know I don't have you for a long time today, so let's ask Luana what she wants to talk about or who's on her guest list today.
Everything and something, I guess, because we talked about the full moon. She's like, it's a super full moon. We want to talk about the moon. I'm actually going to a moon ceremony tonight over at Jessica Alba's house. She invited me over to discuss some of our projects and to have a full moon ceremony. And I'm like, I've never been to one. I don't think I've ever been to a full moon ceremony. So it'll be interesting.
Well, let's ask Luana about that because, you know, this, and for those tuning in for the first or last time, Luana's our friend who passed away in 1996, who introduced Jennifer and me from the flip side and moderates our group from the other side. Go ahead. What she got in mind?
The effects of it. Okay. Never really.
Well, how does that work? You know, I mean, for the average person, we know that the moon affects tidal, you know, activity.
Right, and they've done research. All the hospitals kind of get. They always have to make sure.
I remember, I used to work in a bar in Boston, and the cops said, you know, we don't go into work on a full moon. Yeah. That's what they said.
Okay, hold on. I'll share with you what I'm being shown. I'm being shown like electricity, like, you know, connections being stat, like, I guess missing their connection, but let me.
Oh, so it's almost like it's an eruption of filters in a way. In a Russian, if you tapped your nose, that means yes from the flip side.
Hold on. She says, because people don't really understand what's taking place. Oh. So she showed me, like, literally the door just opening up, being super clear and walking right through it. So, yeah, and we feel this a few days before. Like, last week I got really nervous because I had the chills, like these bone chills, which normally I get if somebody, I'm working on a case and they're trying to ask me for, you know, they're trying to give me information, or if I'm looking for a dead, it's usually because I'm looking for a dead body or something along those lines. And so when I got these chills, of course, I go, I'm like, okay, I'm checking for my family. I'm checking for everything, you know, because my dreams have been crazy. We've already discussed that. And they're like, no, we were celebrating you. You know, we're just super happy. But what she's saying to me, if I'm getting this right, and I'll have her say it again. Hold on. Oh, I know. Hi, Prince. I posted something about Prince and you just said hello. Hello.
Hello, Prince. Oh, you're
Cool.
always welcome here, sir.
He's like, I was so naive. That's
What does
funny.
that mean? What do you mean you were so naive about how things work on the flip side?
About how things work here.
Oh, on the planet. Yeah.
Which is something that he said that was actually really, I thought was really cool, but he's just like, ugh, I was so naive. Hold on. Okay. They're like, calm your head down so we can talk to you. They want to make sure that it's only available to people that you're connected to, like my parents. Like it's not, you know, or somewhat connected to. It's not like
Not random
random.
individual.
You know, bad people can't come in and try to hang out with people that are good or try to make things happen. Hold on. Oh, okay. Wow. So be careful. The other thing that they showed me is be careful about what you're thinking about or vacillating on during this time, because it goes really, the energy is really fast. So if you, like I said, the universe doesn't discriminate. So if you're thinking about, for instance, in my case, time, like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna be late. It just makes me more late versus if I wouldn't have thought about it and just got there and did what I was supposed to do, I probably could have slowed down time for all I know. But they're saying that things speed up really fast during this time, during the full
Well, let
moon.
me ask you, Lou, is that reflective of your experience? That because it seems like on your side of the veil, or whatever you want to call it, everything is exponentially faster. Is it just that we're more open to it?
Belief.
Belief.
Make sure your thoughts are clear and concise. Like, don't want for things because then the universe lets you want them, literally lets you just want them. Prayer is very strong during this time.
So in
And
S, go ahead.
so is your body being in tune. So being in tune with how it should be.
So
So
the
if
essence of a
not, things go awry more so because of the tides of the water and because our bodies are made up of.
mostly water, yeah, or a lot of water. But so what you're saying is that in times like this, let's say, the era of or around a big moon, full moon. That even though it's very subtle, our ability to communicate with the other side is exponentially greater. Is that correct?
Yes. But people don't understand that it's so much more that they think they're not getting it. They're laughing at me because it's so much clearer that sometimes even I'm the biggest skeptic, right? Even I fight with the other side. I'm like, no, it can't be that easy, or it can't be that,
I know
you
we've seen
know.
you do that. Yeah, that's great. We love that.
So if you ask for signs, don't judge what comes through. You know, don't
Don't judge.
and
Yeah.
give them time to figure it out. And it might not, thank you. And it might not be the first thing that you think of. It could be the second or third thing that you think of, or that they pop into your head. And then also don't ask for a sign, then not look. And it could be something that is. Okay, show me again. Oh, so you might be a butterfly, but you might see a butterfly on a bumper sticker, or you might see a girl's tattoo that's a butterfly. It might not be just exactly the way that you think it's gonna
So if you, let's say you ask for, show me a sign, and that person, your loved one, knows that butterflies will indicate that you're communicating, and instead of showing you a literal butterfly, they'll show you sort of a visual.
Right. they're making fun of, I think, a lot of humans. Just be better drivers too during this time. Be more present. Don't, like, because people, thank you, they're showing, like, people tend to, veer off mentally, which I do a lot, because I do some of my best work in the car, because it's just, it's a, I'm actually, I give myself something to do.
There's a bumper sticker. Be careful. The driver is a psychic medium, intuitive. Be careful.
Be careful.
All right. So, Prince, we're not going to boot you out of the chair just because you stopped by to say hi to Jennifer. So, you're here. What do you want to tell us? Anything about your journey or what we should be thinking about on our journey? We've got an election coming up in a couple of weeks. Prince, do you want to make any predictions or tell us how to vote?
It says vote, just vote. Give yourself, vote. Don't complain about, they're showing me somebody that can't vote that complains about our democracy. Yeah, a democracy was given to us for a reason, and use it wisely, and know that it could be taken away if somebody decides that they want to take it away. They've already tried, but just, it's almost like complain where your mouth is. Like, figure it out. Like, get out and vote. That's for starters.
Almost like complaining where your mouth is. I like
Yeah.
that.
Hold on. We have a beautiful country. We live in it. We breathe in it. We utilize so many things with this country of ours, this beautiful country of ours. We're spoiled rotten compared to the rest of the world. Well, not spoiled rotten, but you know what I'm saying. There's a lot of people that are not doing well in our country. I did not mean to say that. Hold on.
So, is this Prince giving his opinion on why we should vote?
He just looks at us as like little brats. Like, you guys are just, hold on.
That's a funny way to put it.
You have no idea what's at stake, what truly is at stake. Get out and vote.
Okay.
Don't
I'm
sit home.
gonna, Prince, I'm gonna quote you on that one. I appreciate that. You have no idea what's at stake. Get out and vote. And we appreciate that from the coming from the flip side. I do have a couple of questions for Luana if she's available to answer them.
She said she put them in your head.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask her about an incident that happened last night.
Okay.
And if she can just characterize, was this incident accurate?
Yes.
Yes.
But there's something that I felt like you saw a double of something and you heard something. It was like a, it was both.
Okay, that's correct. I'm getting a chill as a result of that.
But I don't know, of
You
course.
don't know what it is, but it was related to a dream I was having. But within the dream, something physical happened and it forced me to wake up, and I could feel as if someone had been holding my finger, and I could feel the throbbing in my finger. My ring finger. And so what was that about, Lou? Who AA was that, a boy or girl, a man, a woman? Who was visiting me? All right, don't judge it. I saw that look. This is the fun thing about Jennifer. You ask her a question and she makes it look like I'm not telling you that answer. No. What?
No, it, what came through is your was an Indian chief.
Oh, an Indian chief. Let's not judge it. Very good.
Trying not to,
No,
trying not.
I'll tell you that many, many years ago, I was having a health thing many years ago, way before this research, and I had this kind of weird thought feeling that there was an Indian chief associated with me, and it was like almost like they didn't want to tell me that because they thought I wouldn't understand it. I do now. But what's up with the pulling the finger? Was that I was coming back into my body, or what was that, a request to leave, or was it just to wake up? What was the request?
What it feels like, what I'm feeling, is that it was made from you, like an agreement that you made that you wouldn't go too far out there, that you'd always have a way to get back.
So,
And
in essence, but so the grabbing of my finger, was that me coming back, or was that me going or being pulled, like somebody saying, come with me? That's
being pulled.
Being pulled. And so where did this person want to take me, or what was the issue that they wanted to show me? That's my question.
It's almost like the earth before it started in some way.
Okay.
It's like it was one of your guides.
Let's not judge it. Luana is, go ahead.
I'm getting it that you were either doing research a while ago, or you came across something about how the earth was created. Form.
How we wind up on the planet. But let me ask you, Luana, is this related to Jennifer and me and our work, or is this just some kind of an unusual? I mean, why last night? Was it related to this moon issue that suddenly the filters are down?
Yeah, all of it. Yeah.
And suddenly.
Really, the way that she shows me being able to, like, so if it is somebody that's connected to you, which it feels like it is, it's your guide, I think, or.
A guide, and, that's right, or my guide, that's okay.
And if that's the case, I mean, she's showing me just like a crack in, like a crack in a mirror, being able to go right through, just being able to walk right through. Like it's, that's why I have to sleep with my lights on.
I almost got up and turned the lights on, but I can say is I was speaking in the dream, and I woke people up in our house, you know, because they were like, what's the matter? I was saying there's somebody here.
Yeah.
And I said it over and over again and aloud. I thought I was in the dream. So the somebody was somebody that I know. That's really what my question was. And so I can always examine who that was and why and what the thing was. And
the Buffalo guy, the
the Buffalo guy. It's great. She's talking about Sitting Bull.
Sitting Bull.
Tatanka, Ayote, I forget his name. I'm sorry.
I wouldn't remember. That's why.
So you're saying it's related to this fella. Is that correct?
Yes.
And so Jennifer and I have spoken to Sitting Bull before. We've talked about his life and his death and his message. And we talked about him talking to a white buffalo and other spiritual aspects, but also about a peace pipe that exists in Pasadena that he wanted me to call the museum and say, tell him, don't sell my peace pipe. Anyway, Sitting Bull has come. Sitting Bull, do you want to say anything? What is it you were trying to tell me last night, sir? Let's just ask.
I think it's twofold, but how it's mainly to show, how easy it is to be connected to your guides. We intuitively know that they are always with us, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I think it was a demonstration that they're with us even when we're sleeping. They're with us even when we're, you know, out there, which that means I have a lot of protection up there because I'm out there a lot.
You're out there a lot. That's true.
Okay, show me again. That more than ever, we are helping you. We have just as much interest in what we're doing with the planet, with our democracy, with, you know, with everything that's going on. I mean, think of all the elections that are happening. It's the biggest year of elections that we've seen from what I've, like there's 60 officials all over the world that are being.
Wow. Well, so Sitting Bull, if you don't mind me calling you that, what? Yesterday was Indigenous Peoples Day, no longer called, we've talked to Chris Columbus, no longer called that. But what is it you want to say to people who are tuning in, who want to connect with tribes, Native Indigenous Americans, Lakota, Sioux, helping people? What is it you want to say?
You don't have to smoke a peace pipe to connect with.
To connect. Okay. And so what's a good way to connect with you, sir?
Oh, wow. Think about all your ancestors, regardless of race and ethnicity. Think about all the shoulders that we stand on here today. Stop taking for granted what so many have fought for.
Ooh. I feel that.
And start loving the life that you have, regardless of Like, don't compare it to other parts of your life. Like I said, I said it's a lot easier for me to think of myself as a visitor because I know from the other side, no one takes anything with you. You don't take anything with you. And we call it the play, right? And I think of it more as a game. Like, I think that I've had some pretty crazy experiences recently that have shown me how nothing's outside of us. Nothing. It's, I had an experience that I believe I kind of saw or felt. I don't want to say God, but I left my body during a meditation so much, though, that I actually think that I was so far out there that when I got there, I'm like, oh, it's just a game. Like, I literally had this moment, but there was nobody that, like, so you weren't outside, everything was inside. It was everything was like under this umbrella of inside of me. Like, I have created all of these characters in my universe, right? And all these universes that intersect, but it's made part of the whole. But anyway, I really felt, I think I had an NDE. I have no idea, but I definitely felt, I've only felt this twice. And it was something that I will never ever forget. And there's it did something to my brain. Like, I have a whole different, like, way of looking at things. It's very interesting for me.
Wow. If I may, and this is reflective of what you're saying. So in the research, near-death experience research, 85%, this is according to Dr. Grayson, 85% experience source or God. And they did, and the way he characterized it is they experience indescribable joy, unconditional love, and non-judgmental acceptance. And you and I hear that often in this research where we ask people, like, what's your experience? My father came to me when he passed away, and that was the first thing he said, I'm experiencing indescribable joy. I'd never heard the term before, and now hearing it all the time. And so you had this experience. Would you characterize those three as part of it?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Like, oh, I was so, and I also didn't have any regrets. Like, there was no sadness. Even if I at that time I thought, oh, I'm not going to see my kids again, but my kids were me. Like, my friends were me. Like, everybody was me. It
We're
was
all part of that.
something to explain. It really is something that I can't, that's the closest I can to explaining it.
You know, it's interesting. Also, we've heard this. I mean, we heard a guide in divine counsels in the afterlife say, God is beyond the capacity of the human brain to comprehend, but you can experience God by opening your heart to
Yes.
everyone and all things. And what you're saying is that experience, it's they call it an oceanic experience, where suddenly you feel connected to trees, plants,
Everything.
everything. Wow. I know Dr. Mario Beauregard had that experience when he was a teen, and that's why he became a neuroscientist, to understand, like, what happened, you know. And it's so rare. I had the experience once, and you've just had it. And well, that's amazing. I mean, we characterize it as something different than what we are. But, you know, I was talking to someone the other day about what is nirvana. It's the idea, you know, the teachings are about going to, and what I'm trying to tell people is we come from nirvana. We come here to experience life and all the stuff that's not nirvana, trees and whatever, but it's all reflective of that. And then when we leave the stage, we go home, back to that place in Indiana called Nirvana, whatever that is.
It's been, it was quite, it's done something. It
It's
really has
very
done.
profound. I know I don't have you for long, but I do have one more question, if I can. Amelia came up yesterday in a profound way, and I need to ask her a question, and it's on behalf of somebody who reached out to me and was like, you know, does this person, you know, their screenplay, is this something they should pursue, or should I pursue the book that I'm planning on writing about her? Which one should the book? That's all I can do is ask that question. I understand the answer.
I feel like the book's going to create something
It
too.
will
Like,
create a movie. It'll create this thing. It'll create so much because there's going to be so much in there. And somebody reached out to me yesterday and said, hey, where's that Amelia book? And I went, oh my gosh, it's so weird you would reach out. Well, Jennifer, I can't thank you enough. I mean, we talked to Prince. Thank you, dude. And wow, what a profound way to put it. We talked to Sitting Bull. How unusual is that?
Like it was so fascinating to see. Like I felt the clean rivers that he was showing me, like all the things that they had to do just to keep their own land that got, you know, I mean, we won't go into the history of what else, but nobody's just like, get out there and make it, like you guys are standing on our shoulders. Like if you want, have us, we will be more than happy to show you what we've been through so you can be. So you, which is probably us, but the future versions of ourselves or the ones that our souls are connected to, can do this, can be here, you know? And I'm like, I forget that. I don't have that in my memory every day. But if we like, oh my goodness. I mean, the women, what they had to do to even vote, like that alone, and that's not that long ago.
No, and people are so willing to give it all up in just a heartbeat. And also, thank you for sharing your experience with Source or God or whatever term you want to use, but that interconnectivity of all things in the universe. I mean,
it's something that has made me look, like I said, I have such a different outlook. It's just, and I can be so grateful for all the things I do have. I just don't have that right now. I know it's, I want to be in this space forever, but I'm sure
it's not going to happen.
But if I could remember just those bits and pieces of just that joy and that fun and that, like, you just the times that are wasted over stupid things and petty things. Like, if you can get to a place where you never have to want anything because you're so happy no matter where you are, you know, I think that's kind of what I don't know. That's
kind of why we're on the planet, I think. It's part of our journey. And sharing this stuff and helping people out there tuning in, listening in, driving in their car going, what is this? And realizing that you can tune in to yourself, to your heart, to your loved ones, and learn new information.
Heart coherence, because I think my meditation was about 2 hours, and it was like an hour of getting into your heart. And expanding your heart and its awareness. And that's, I think that's what catapulted me. I don't remember. It felt like 5 minutes and it was 2 hours. That's wow. What it felt like. I was gone for like just 5 minutes and it was 2 hours. It was one of those crazy things that I'm like, okay, well, I also talk to dead people and see people, like, so just chalk it up to whatever. But this one, I'm like, that was for me. And I couldn't be more excited. And that was brought through from meditation. So
I think it's beautiful. And you notice we don't ask questions about a particular entity in that example, in those examples. We just realize that it's part of who we are, our interconnectivity.
Yes. Yep. All right.
We love you, Jennifer. Thank you so much. What a treat to catch you today.
It was wonderful. All right.
Love, bye. Love. This has been Hacking the Afterlife podcast with Jennifer Shaffer. For more information, jennifershaffer.com, martinizone.com, or richmartini.com. Hacking the Afterlife documentary is available on gaia.com via Amazon Prime.